The Death Transition, Crossing Over.
Hi, y'all. I had a friend email me today in regards to what does it feel like to cross over, you know, when you die and that kind of thing. And I was going to email her back, but my guide said, hey, how about doing a video about it and sharing it? Now, I remember a long time ago when I was under my psychic attacks, I had an out-of-body experience, and it was very frightening to me because I was asleep, but the next thing I know, I felt like I was awake, and I was looking down, and I saw my body, and I was up way high above my roof line. I mean, I felt that's how high up I was, but I don't remember seeing my house. I just remember seeing my body. And in a flash, I was back in my body. Now, I don't think my body had died, but, you know, I was laying there awake. I mean, once my consciousness was back in that body, I was totally awake. I was In fact, I felt depleted. I felt drained. And it really upset me because I'm like, what the heck next? You know, why don't you people just leave me alone? Well, anyway, after I emailed her back and said I was going to do a video about it, the next thing I know, I had three spirits. And this whole scenario, you're going to think it's either funny or strange because I thought it was both. But first, I have someone that's standing next to me saying, yeah, I'm Patrick Swayze, and I want you to tell him my experience. And then, so a few minutes went by, and it says, next thing, it's like, John says he wants you to do his too, meaning John Lennon. And I'm like, okay, anybody else? Just jokingly. And the next thing I know, I get, yeah, well, George said you can do his too. And I'm like, George Harrison? Well, yeah. And I'm like, okay. And so I went out to eat with my husband, and I decided I'd do the video later. And the next thing I know, here I've got every relative under the sun coming at me saying, you can do mine, you can do mine, you can tell them about me. I'm like, hey, it's only a 10-minute video. And I mean, I can make more on it, but it was just like, you know, I made so many videos this week, and I don't want to bore you guys. But the dying experience. So let's go into this. There are so many scenarios, okay? I remember a past lifetime where I felt like I was dying. In my mind, I felt like I was poisoned. I was laying in bed, and the next thing I know, my spirit's coming out of the body because I was being told by the universe to get up out of the bed and get up. So I see my soul coming out of the body standing there. Now, that's a past life, so I'm thinking, okay, you know, nobody has to believe it. But you can get with your guardian angels or your spirit guides, and you can discuss your past lives and what you felt like when you crossed over or went out into the spirit world. It's a phenomenal experience to experience at least once. Now, in the sense that this thing about Patrick Swayze, I felt like he was nagging at me to tell, you know, what happened with him. The only image I got in my mind is him standing there looking at his body, standing in the room. He was just standing there looking at his body. And I think he had enough concept to understand that he had crossed over, but there was some longing in him that said he didn't want to believe it. You know, he didn't want to believe that this was final. But then he realized it's not final because obviously he's standing there looking at his body. But a lot of people that cross over don't understand the concept of reincarnation or eternity. I mean, when they do cross over and finally it hits them, hey, I'm still alive, you know, then yeah, it does hit them. Now, in the sense of John Lennon, he gave me a message that was basically he didn't know what was going on. He felt something. He felt himself fall to the ground. He knew something bad was going on. It all just happened, he said, pretty suddenly. But he felt like, you know, he just had this pressure on him. And he remembers just all of a sudden, like his body hit the ground, and then he was standing next to his body. Again, kind of like that Patrick Swayze movie Ghost. He's looking at his body, he's looking over at his wife, and he's like, oh my God, what's going on here? That kind of thing. Now, with George, when he brought me the message later about him, he felt like he had been asleep, pretty much like my grandmother, my mom, you know, where they were in a long-term illness. He felt like he was just asleep, and he was asleep for a while, and then all of a sudden he woke up, and he said he just realized he was awake. But then he remembers looking down and seeing people and thinking, where's my body? And all of a sudden he said he got this message, there isn't a body. So I know when you are out there, you do get these messages. You have people around you that communicate to you, that talk to you, to help you a lot of times. Now, there's some times where you may be a loner and you have no one, or you may feel like you're alone and you have no one. There's so many different scenarios. Let's see, what did I leave out here? So, like, yeah, my grandma, my mom, you know, they probably, or they said that they felt like they were just there staring at their bodies and they realized they were gone. But, again, a state of mind. What you believe in, as far as your religious beliefs, you could have, you know, in your mind, you could be thinking you're looking for God or Jesus or Muhammad or any of the religious leaders that you believe in, because that's what you've been brought up to believe. You can have family meeting you when you cross over, in the sense of an accident. You know, if a child is in an accident and it's such a traumatic thing, they're in the body and then they're out of the body and they're looking around like, what's going on? You could have an out-of-body experience and your body could still be alive. They could be working on the body and you could be standing there looking at them like cheering them on, please get me alive kind of thing. But you're still out of the body. And then all of a sudden you'll feel like, okay, you can go back now, that kind of thing. So there's so many different things that can be experienced. All these people that talk about these near-death experiences or out-of-body experiences, they're so right on with their feelings. It's not phony. It's not fake. And when you can communicate to spirits and they tell you what they've gone through themselves personally, am I running out of time now? Then you can understand that this isn't an eternal life, that there is a lot of things that people can go through and experience when it comes to their physical dying, their bodies dying, and their spirits still going on. Gosh, I think I've gotten everything, guys. And my Uncle Joe. Okay. It's been a long time since he passed away, and he told me, honestly, he thought he had something else. But I called my dad to confirm it because I was getting doubt off of him. And my dad said, no, he had a stroke, and then he had several strokes afterwards, and he passed away. But my aunt has cancer. So I think he was picking up something about cancer because of my mom and my aunt. You know, a lot of times too, something can happen so tragically that you can block it out of your mind. You don't want to know. It's like I was talking to my dad, you know, it's so long ago that you tend to forget, you know, what was it that I died from? Or like he says, or you don't want to remember. And I said, well, that's true too. You know, it's a tragic thing. So you would have a block. You would block it from your mind because of it. So, but anyway, I wanted to share this with you. Please understand, I cannot do videos on everybody's family members that have passed away or loved ones. I would love to, but I really cannot make the time for that right now. Because of the Soul Start videos that I'm doing, it's very time consuming. And of course, if you see this video and you've never seen any of my other videos and you want to get like nasty and make nasty remarks, I will block you. I will delete your comment. I don't need it. Okay. I'm doing this to help people who seriously are interested in life and life after. And if you want to show your ignorance, you know what, keeping your thoughts to yourself or go share them with someone else, because I'm not interested. I'm doing this to help people. And when people come to me from the spirit world and say, please share my experience, they don't want your ugliness either. Okay, so now I want to thank all my family who has crossed over, who wanted me to share this experience with them. I want to thank, you know, George and John and Patrick for sharing their experiences with me. And I think, you know, all my guides, if you have any questions, please ask. I don't want to really answer a lot of like my dad died or my mom died or whatever, you know, because it's just too time consuming for me. But if you have a general question that I didn't really touch in on this video, let me know and I'll see what I can do to get my guides to help me answer it for you. Okay. Hugs and peace, everybody. Bye bye.
My brother asked me to include his experience. He died in a tragic accident at the old Tampa Stadium when he fell to his death. It was fearful and painful. He said after he hit the ground, he remembers getting up, looking at his body, but not being in pain.